him a bit of gratitude, thanked him for sharing his billboards with Eagle Farm during his last campaign. In fact, it did so much to help us. We had hundreds of inquiries and even over 100 new members whose new motto now is Eagle Scout and Eagle Farm. There's only one thing I would like to say. Ben, next time, in your next campaign, will you please put my contact information on? You left it off this time. But I also have to say that when the mayor called me and asked me if I'd participate tonight to come and celebrate Jim's retirement party, I was really excited to do that. Very, very enthusiastic about being here tonight. I got here tonight all excited and found out that he wasn't retiring from the Senate. But, you know, why would I care who the chairman of the Democratic Party is? But, just a couple of weeks ago, the atheists were here in town having their annual convention right here in Utah. And I was listening to the radio on the news, and I heard there was another convention in town that same weekend. It was a convention with a lot of people dressed up in costumes, running around as superheroes, thinking they were going to save the world. And that was really confusing to me because I thought the Democratic Convention was the next weekend. And, you know, the legislative session just ended, and as usual, they passed some really ridiculous laws. One of the laws that they passed was one called, you know, distracted driver. That was sponsored by Mr. Anti-Discrimination himself, Senator Lockhart. Talk about discrimination. You know, that bill discriminates against us old people. Old people don't have those fancy, you know, newfangled telephones that you talk into and they dial somebody's number. In fact, most of us still have the original telephone that we have. And no matter how many times we yell up into that phone, screaming and yelling all the way up down the highway, asking it to call somebody, it never calls anybody. Talk about distracted driving. But you know, I have to say that I have great respect for Senator Dabakis here. You know, he has such enthusiasm for his liberal causes that he inspires people to get involved. He inspires people to call their legislators and stand up for what they believe in. It's about time somebody said fire to those Republicans. In fact, my telephone tree is so large right now that it makes my genealogy chart look like a bonsai tree. So Jim, you need to stick around because I think Peter's going to need some instructions. But I just want to say, Senator Dabakis, that you are my friend. And I'm grateful to be here tonight, and I share with you, and I want you to know that I have concerns, and I pray for you, and I pray that you will have good health. And I want to say this: though we disagree, and we do disagree on issues, and we have a lot of disagreements at the legislature, that has nothing to do with our friendship, because our friendship is based on respect, and I call you my friend. There's one more surprise. So I want to invite to the stage Sister Dottie Dixon. Woo!
Hi, Gayle. It's been so long. It's great to see you, sister. I was already there, sister. Some of you may not know that Gayle and I was sorority sisters down to the BYU. Kappa Kappa Helaman. Remember that big panty raid? Well, all about called into President Davenport's office. Oh, it was up there. Yeah, good looking. frightened and terrified. That day, I was watching that Phyllis Schlafly on TV, speaking of the Eagle Farm, and she was going on and on about lowering the minimum wage and all that. Do you think you'll take her place when she kicks the bucket? Never. Well, Gayle, honey, I'm so honored to be on the stage with you here tonight. Such a photo opportunity, I never thought would be afforded to me in my whole life. I've got you some presents, Gayle. Here's a copy of my CD. It's called This I Know. Here's a signed copy of the Mormon Kama Sutra. Me and Pat Bagley got it. It says practice now, Gayle, practice. Here's a box of my signature candy. You can munch on those while you listen to me roast Jimmy. Oh, and here is an autographed picture of me, Sister Dottie. Everybody wants one. Hope it's on your fridge when I come up. And lastly, I brought you some things for your bumper. Here's a sticker for Restore Our Humanity, Support Marriage Equality. Here's one from the HRC, Love Conquers Hate. You slide that around, they'll send you some free Avon. And my very favorite, I hope to see this on the back of your minivan. I'm ready for Gayle.
Would you run it in the Senate?
Hughes replace Bob Bennett? Would you run it here or there? Would you run it with an opening prayer? Would you, could you, as the mayor? Now that would make Salt Lake a whole lot gayer. You like to be the bossy man. You like to strut that bossy can. You do, dear Jimmy Wham, especially in front of a TV cam. When you post, you like to glow, I guess, so all the money will flow. Within your step, you have a swagger, but please be careful of the dagger. Blah, 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 when you are a topper, make sure you know Troy Williams is stopper. What will you do, dear Jim UM? Please don't forget to expose the sham. Would you, could you, here or there? Would you, could you, anywhere? Will you do it in D.C.? You're gonna have to become PC. In the house with your friend named Klaus. Oh, it's Igor. I get those two always mixed up. Maybe with the GOP. Please say no, I would just have to pee. We do not like you, that you may be done. Good hell, you've only just begun. Would you go on with this with great flair if we gave you a big old dare? You won't go on, so you say, please, Jim. Please, Jim, we pray, pray, pray. Well, if you will, we'll promise this. We'll fill your hearts, and we'll feel great bliss. He am Jim, Jim he am, that Jim he am, that Jim he am, we just adore that Jim he am. Thank you all, good night. All right, thank you everybody.